Melissa and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm getting into a tag video. The concept is that if I could only keep one bag per designer brand, which one would I keep? Now I've seen it done where it's like one item per brand, so you could pick shoes or accessories, and I've also seen the tag where it's one bag per designer. So I don't know which one came first. I tried to figure it out, I tried to look through it, but it is a tag video and I've seen several people do it, so this is not my original concept. I was inspired by other creators and the multiple videos I saw. And let me just say, I had a difficult time picking because I didn't know whether to go for the practical choice or like the most special bag I have from that designer. This list is a bit of a mix because, I mean, I guess if you can get one per brand, you can have some functional ones and some non-functional ones. I think my picks might surprise you. By the way, if you're new here, hi, my name is Morgan. I make videos about luxury handbags, fashion, and lifestyle. So if that's your thing, please subscribe and turn on notifications. I upload twice a week and I would love to have you here. And let's get into my designer bag choices if I could only pick one bag from each brand. First up is Chanel. This is definitely one of the hardest decisions I had to make on this list, and I went for my medium pink cocoa handle. And the reason why I did this is because Chanel pinks are my favorites. I love their pinks, and this pink is not necessarily my favorite in my collection, but this is a great shade of pink that, depending on what you're wearing, it can look more like a neutral medium pink, or it can kind of take on that salmony pink look as well. So this really goes with so much in my wardrobe. The medium cocoa handle is hands down my favorite style from Chanel and the most functional and still worth the price, even though it is very premium. A classic flap doesn't function enough for me, which I know that would probably be most people's choice on this list. But for me, the cocoa handle gives me more versatility in use, and it fits all the items I need for every day, plus some. I never run out of space in this bag, and it's just such like a hard-working bag in my wardrobe. The next brand on my list is Dior, and I don't have a lot of Dior bags, and honestly, if I had the Lady Dior, that would probably be on my list. I am still on the hunt, but I haven't decided the color yet. Considering that I don't have that in my collection, my choice was my vintage Dior saddle bag. This is one that, like, when they relaunched, I remember how much I love this bag. I was too young to really have such an expensive bag at the time that it launched. I just love the fun patterns of a Dior saddle bag. Of course, I love vintage bags in general, but I think has the most significance in fashion history besides the Lady Dior brand. It's Celine, and I would go for my Nano luggage. I love the mini, which is not really mini, you know, like the big giant one, and that's the one I've had for the longest in my collection. But it's a very heavy bag, and I feel like it gets scratched very easily. This one I got pre-loved more recently, and yes, it does have a bit of structure wear, but I think the grained leather is much better. So if I had to keep one in my collection, I would definitely keep the Nano. I think it's also a more functional size. It doesn't weigh nearly as much as the mini size does. I love that this comes with a crossbody strap. This is a throw on and go. It can go casual. If you take the strap off and hold it like this, you can manage to make it like dressy for evenings as well. This can be a really cute handheld bag. So it has a lot of versatility in the wardrobe as well. And that's why I think I would definitely keep this one over my mini size. This brand is Fendi, and I think I only have one Fendi bag, so it would be my Baguette. But quite honestly, I can't think of a more iconic shape from Fendi. Maybe the Peekaboo. I've always wanted to add a Peekaboo, but again, it's that type of bag. I know I would only want one in my collection, and I just haven't decided a color. But in terms of like iconic designer bags, a Fendi Baguette is one of those that I feel like every collector has some version of this. If it's the mini, it's this size, it's vintage, it's new. A Baguette, I think, just serves a wardrobe so well. It's just a tuck under the shoulder bag. I think even though I only have one Fendi, such an iconic choice that it would be my choice even if I had other Fendi bags. Now we're on to Saint Laurent, and hands down, it has to be any bag in the India pink color. Even though I have my beautiful rainbow python and that's my special piece, this color is one that every time I see it, I'm like obsessed with this India pink. It's just the most gorgeous pink. They didn't do a lot of styles in this color, so I would love to have like one of the bigger shoulder bags, like in the similar type of quilting, but I haven't seen anything like that. I don't even know if that was ever made, but I would have to keep this color in my collection. Though I have more functional and more special bags from Saint Laurent, this color is just my favorite and I'd have to keep it in my collection. This brand on my list is Hermes, and the reason I don't have one in my hands is because I have to say coming soon. I might have done a thing and the unboxing will be coming soon to my channel after I'm back from the US, but I don't think it would be fair to put out this list and say my picotin, obviously because it's my only Hermes bag currently in my collection, but I have a feeling that this new bag I'm going to unbox is going to be the bag that I would keep if I could only keep one Hermes bag. So I'm just going to leave it there and say to be continued. The next brand on my list is Bulgari, and I would keep my Lingerie Green, that's not the name of the color, that's just what I call it, Serpentine bag. I do have the teeny tiny matching one, but if I'm only gonna keep one, obviously I'm gonna keep the functional one. Definitely this color, I love this color. I wish that this was made with the top handle. At least when I was shopping, they didn't have it. They had like the bigger kind of flat version and this one only and like the tiny one. I think if I had a top handle from Bulgari, that would be my one to keep. But since I don't, I have to go for the functional one. This is a really great alternative to the Chanel small. I think it probably fits about the same. And it has card slots, so you don't have to keep a card holder or like a wallet inside. I think having those card slots makes this feel much bigger than a Chanel small. So considering its size is quite little, it's a very functional bag and has really great organization, and I just adore this color. The next brand on my list is Prada, and I think this will come as no surprise, my Crystal re-edition. I know this is a more special piece, but I find this actually to be the most versatile Prada that I own. I mean, look at the sparkle. I can wear this on evenings out. I think it looks really great with like matching athleisure sets, like if you've got like biker shorts with the matching shirt, like all in the same color. I wear that a lot with sneakers. That's a great way to wear this bag in the daytime. It also looks great with like if you wear with light colored denim and like a blouse. I think it's one of those that even though it's kind of extra and over the top, it just works in a lot more outfits than I thought. The only thing it doesn't really work for is like my floral dresses, but I think the Coco handle I picked for this list would cover my like floral dresses in my wardrobe, so I had to pick the special piece for Prada. Now we'll get into my choice for Gucci. And as much as I love my Jackie, I would have to pick my Ken Scott Gucci collaboration horsebit bag. It has this beautiful Gucci floral print on it. This is the most classic and timeless Gucci bag I probably could buy to fit my wardrobe and my collection. The horsebit is my favorite hardware from Gucci. It has the most history, and I love when a piece has design history to it. Shape is such that it feels current and also vintage at the same time, which tells me that this will be one that I can wear for decades and it's not ever gonna look super out of place. I think that this is something that can serve my wardrobe for a very long time, even though it is quite a special piece. Gucci florals are done throughout the years. This has every classic element that I could want from a Gucci bag, that if I couldn't have any other bag, I wouldn't need another one. Next brand is Balenciaga, and I would have to keep the most practical choice, my City in the size small, in black gold hardware. I know this is like the most basic choice you're probably gonna see on this list. Honestly, this bag has served me so well. This bag is 6 years old now. It hardly looks like it's been used. I am not precious with this. I've banged it into things, you know. It's been in rain, snow, like any type of weather you can imagine, this bag has lived through. So this bag ages so well. This is a designer bag that will serve me for a lifetime. The next brand is Louis Vuitton, and when I tell you this was the hardest decision on this list, I went back and forth on this for so long because I always like go through and kind of pre-plan my notes when I'm making a list like this so I can be really thoughtful and give you like my proper recommendations. Louis Vuitton was difficult because I realized Louis Vuitton is the brand I go to buy the most functional bags. The bags that work hardest in my wardrobe are from Louis Vuitton. My travel bags, daily use bags, you know, those types of bags that really serve your wardrobe in a way where they're carefree and you can just put the use on them and function in your daily life. I'm gonna have to go the basic route in this and say my Neverfull and the Escal collection. There's just something about this. A Neverfull is so freaking functional. Like, I don't have another tote on this list, so obviously I had to keep one tote. And if I'm gonna keep any tote, it's gonna be this one. The color palette is so me. It's so functional. You know, a tote is a tote. Whatever brand you get it from is not really that different. It's just shoulder straps and a big open hole. It's really not like a design wonder, but it's a bag everyone loves because it's so functional in a wardrobe. Even though I was really tossing up between my new Capucines bag, because I know that's a lifetime bag for me, and also my Pochette Matisse, because that's such a good daily use bag, really this was so hard. But I had to go for the Neverfull because I needed a tote on this list, and I think that this is my favorite one, especially because of the colors. The brand is Givenchy, and of course I had to keep my Antigona in the size small. I don't know what it is. I know people say it's not on trend, but I feel like this is a trend bag that has really transcended time and is now a classic, especially when you see this in black or brown or those kind of more neutral, deeper tones. I think this is such a great daily use and work bag, especially if you're commuting. It fits so much. You can get a small water bottle in here. This is like a hard-working bag, maybe not necessarily in the pink itself. And if you flip it to this side, there's no branding. So it's one of those, it's a little more discreet luxury as well. And it's served my wardrobe for a very long time, and I think it will continue to serve my wardrobe for many years to come. And sometimes I use it more and sometimes I use it less, but this is a bag that I just don't think I could ever part with in my wardrobe. The next brand is Chloe, and I would keep a Chloe test. Now, I am getting rid of this one because this color pink is not the right pink for me, but if I had this in black, hands down, this would be like the Chloe I would keep. I love the Nile, and I would have kept that if it fit phones, and this fits my huge phone, so this is one where you get the real Chloe look. It has two different straps. I keep them stored inside just to keep them nice and neat, but you have that versatility of making it a shoulder bag, making it a crossbody bag. I think this style is so functional, so Chloe, with like the mixed metal hardware and, you know, the simple branding here, that I think this in black or a different color that suits my wardrobe better would be the one that I would have to keep. The last brand on my list is Valentino. I know there's probably some brands that maybe I don't have bags from that are not on this list, or I probably missed one in, you know, trying to make this list, but I tried to make sure I covered all like the major luxury brands in my wardrobe. But from Valentino, I think you'd be surprised, but I would have to keep my Rock Stud clutch. One, because I don't really have like a clutch on this list, and two, because it's such a good pop with a lot of the things I wear in the evening. There's just something about this clutch that really works well in my wardrobe that if I did need something for an event, this would be what I would reach for. My Valentino clutch is my favorite clutch that I own. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know what you thought about my selections. Did any of them surprise you? And don't forget to follow me on Instagram to see how I style my bags. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.